Welcome back from that commercial break. You are still watching Saloon Talk, and I'm still your girl, Sylvaria Hughes. We are here at Spectra Saloon in Bugolobi. If you want self-care, whatever, whether it's massage, whether it's to cut your beard, whether it's makeup, whether to plait, whatever you want, as long as it's about self-care, they have it right here at Spectra Saloon in Bugolobi. Make sure that you come down and get the finest attached. Before we went for the commercial break, we were still talking about the whole episode is revolved around gifting process. Does it have an impact? So now we are going to cover the impact that it has to people. We're going to start with Flex. What feeling is derived, you as a person, you as an individual, what feeling is derived in you when someone gifts you? Let me say, because gifting has the element of surprise. You do not know what someone is going to get you. So there is that rush of emotions and feelings. So in that moment when, let me give an example of your partner. She knows it's your birthday or it's just the Valentine's. Let us not say birthday, because birthday, it's the must. You must get a gift, whether you like it or not. Even though you don't get, it's a must. So better make sure you tell your friends, because if they're not gifting you, I don't think those are your real friends. So flex the paper. What are those emotions that fill you in when you receive a lovely gift from someone that you really care about?
Definitely feels good. 100%. The surprise, obviously. For example, you know, we're used to getting things. That's the honest truth. There's when it becomes obvious.
Yeah,
you're going to get this, which is good, you know. But when you get something
randomly,
from your partner or someone like that, and something special, it's different, you know. Yeah, the emotions, and it feels good. Yeah. Okay. It boosts everything.
Boosts the emotions. So, Lina, what would be in your mind when it's not your birthday, it's not like a Valentine's Day, it's just a normal day. Someone comes out just to profess their love to you, and they grant you something you've always wanted. What is that? What are those feelings that cloud your mind at that moment?
If it's not my boyfriend, I would think otherwise. Or let's say if it's not my man.
But would I just be happy?
I would definitely be happy.
Yeah.
I would be very happy, and I would feel very important in that person's life. Because, man, gifting, doesn't come from anyone.
True.
Yeah, I would feel very relevant and very important in that person's life. Yeah.
Okay. So, buddy, same question goes to you.
Yeah, actually, gifting is important. It adds more impact. Like, when you're gifting me, I'll feel like I'm loved. First of all, even if I don't like what you've given me, like, the fact that you've thought about me and you're gifting me is okay. You feel me, eh? So it's actually good and healthy, eh? Yeah.
Do you guys really think it's good to be, like you said, it's healthy to be gifted, but there are those that really go out of their way just to gift their partner. For example, you are out there, you have a savings, or you have a savings account, you have a savings box, but you end up cracking it just to make sure that it doesn't matter whether it's your lover, it can be your father, your mother, someone you really, really, really care about, because it does not only, because gifting goes very wide. It can be a party, that's a gift. Someone can gift you a party, like, that's your thing, but that also needs income. So do you think it's wise if someone goes down to their savings and breaks their account just to make someone happy, or do you think that's really, really immature?
It's okay. Like, if the timing is you're gifting somebody and you don't have that money, it's okay to do whatever, like getting from your savings. But you have to work hard so that when you're gifting this person, make sure the money is there by the time you're gifting. Yeah, so that you don't feel like, because there's getting from your savings, you buy somebody maybe what, a nice cent, and this person won't like it because some people be like, what you take it, right? So make sure the person you're gifting or mumani, you know what they want, and you have to be that kamani. Yeah. Don't get from your savings because you want to impress somebody.
Yeah, but there are also this type of people whereby, yes, they may not be having a lot of savings, but by nature, by nature, they like you said, you always want to gift someone so that they will do the same to you. So there are these type of people whereby they gift and nebe malamu like nayagala kugulia the whole world, like nebe malamu completely to zero.
I think it depends. For you to break your bank to just give someone, maybe, you know, there's when you do it, maybe for your child. Your child has graduated. You know, that's a milestone. Maybe it's the first child in your entire family to graduate. Yeah, that's there, yeah. You know. So you want to create them a very big party, you know. So you go all out, maybe even sell something small because that's something, that's a milestone. I think people do that. I mean, the kid will bring it back when they get jobs or whatever. But with this Uganda, okay, we don't know about jobs. But you know what I mean? Then also there's maybe another scenario whereby someone, maybe you've won something like very big that you won,
sure.
Like maybe you've
award,
been having, and
you know,
yeah, you
a
get
Grammy,
so you feel that 100%
yeah.
You get,
yeah.
So you feel that maybe you deserve to do that, you go all out, you know. But then at the same time, maybe for like let me just give an example, like maybe someone at university here, you know, and there's some kabeb you like, you know, you have your little savings on your phone or whatever. Now I've given you your tuition, but you know the babe goes out maybe to Mezanwa, you know. She goes to all those, you know, she's that high end babe, and you want to please her, and then you end up,
you love
like,
investing in
you get you end up
for.
Yeah, and yet that's not what you want, but you think you like maybe to impress her. I'm going to do this and that. And after you've done all that, she's like, okay, thanks. That was good. Blah, blah, blah.
Thanks. Oh,
and,
my God.
Yeah. And you're down for the entire semester, you know, things like that, your tuition or whatever. I don't think that's wise in that kind of way. So, yeah.
I also think it depends on the perception someone has on specific days. Valentine's may not be a special day to me. I don't consider it. I'm giving an example. To me, it may not be a special day. To someone else, it may be very, very special because the perception we have of certain days is very different. So if for me, if it's Valentine's, even Happy Valentine's is enough. And then for someone else, he'll feel like, I really need to make this woman feel special.
Very true. That's very true.
Yeah, so I think how we perceive certain days also matters.
I think that also goes to what he said. You have to know your partner and what they really want. Because most cases, people have... there are people out there, girls, that have 4 birthdays in a year. Eh? Like today, in January, she has mid-year, she has...
Yeah, those are making money. Stay there. Because you can't have 4 birthdays in a year,
yeah,
man.
Birthday celebration.
And they're actually
like
wise
that.
At it. Ochitega cause ajateka home new year wataleta moto
katakwa wise because I don't know how to, cause they keep telling the same people. Because I had a friend, this story will make you laugh. Sorry. I had a friend of mine, we were back in high school. She said she had 4 birthdays and we were like, okay, elaborate. But she was born in December and she was premature, so they had put her in an incubator. So then they removed her for the first time from the incubator. That's also the second birthday.
Auntie Kati. That's what I'm telling you. They are wise and smart at it because they know they're working. I think in most cases, they actually receive a lot. Yeah, so you have to be that wise.
Last year, I organized my birthday party. I actually texted a lot of people to come. Obviously, you don't tell someone, come with a gift. It is automatic. If I am buying you the drinks, I'm paying your food. Like, because food is free. Like, I'm the one paying it.
I don't think it's automatic.
No, that's why some people... That's why some people...
Very many birthdays. Everyone attends those birthdays with nothing.
No, if you know you're attending a birthday party...
Not even a bottle.
If you know you're attending a birthday party and you did not... No, there are some birthday parties whereby
you
don't...
You know what she's trying to say? She has invested a lot and she wants to get the money.
Not getting
through
the
gifts.
Money back. It is like someone appreciating you.
I know you're okay. You're
day.
Having a good time with
you're
them,
having a good time.
But at the same time, you've also
why
got
am I
something
paying for your drinks. I am because it's my party. I have to cater for it. I have bought the drinks because I've taken you guys out. I bought the drinks. There is a cake. That is all my.
Okay, in that instance, that makes sense. Why you've created? You're done. Was paid for the party. You've done this. So obviously, like you said, common sense. They'll have to bring you gifts. Blah blah blah. But that's not like common sense. Is not common. Like they say. However, though, the these ones who say, oh, it's a birthday party, everyone's contributing 200k for my party. No, I'm not supposed to. You get,
yeah, no,
I don't want
that's
to,
yes.
You get,
but
so,
I think we should develop these things.
You get
a
thing. So people need maybe, because maybe an SUAs are really close,
sure
you have a certain group, and then you will be like, oh, let's contribute for let's contribute for your birthday. Everyone's like, oh, let's bring 200k, let's do this. And, you know, that's maybe also there. But not the thing of like, everyone's texting, then the guy is calling you, mwe, ngate muna wateka ko sente za birthday yangi.
You should actually have friends who can do that.
Which who can give you a surprise
Yeah, because if you know you have struggling friends and you expect them to to give you the 200 like everybody, they're also struggling, man.
Yeah. But they wish you well.
So make sure you have those friends that can do that. Then the other thing is create value for yourself. Nobody's going to give you 200K. Ngachimanyi.
Yeah, like you're ordinary. Eh?
Yeah, make sure you're worth the 200. Yeah?
Wow. No,
sikuwa nyuna emazima reality. Make sure you have these friends that can give you that money.
Yeah, but that's okay. That's very true because it's different when you ask people to contribute for your party. But what I said, we should pick a leaf from the Western people, like the whites out there. Yes, asking someone to contribute for a gift, that can be overmuch. But like I said, if I have invested and then they could work a shwee, they don't even give
you. But at times it might be your partner who has created, like set up the party for you, and then your partner invites your close friends.
Those close friends will come.
They won't bring gifts. Like this is common. I'm sure like 70% of these birthday parties, people just come for vibes. I mean, you've invited me. Let's go and turn up. It's your birthday.
Yeah, but then you get. Okay, social media, because normally if the birthday girl when she comes, there's that gift session. Eh? So it's Oswala these days when you've just attended someone's party without at least. Do you know by the people these days just for social media? They bring you a huge box, Nenga Munda. There is a sock, one couple of socks. Nenga, the box is very, very huge.
Let me tell you, there's people who are doing that, they're earning from it, they're actually getting more. When you do that to yourself, this guy out there, Akwagala, this is a level, so now they do it, now money they are gonna get like more, like attract more 10 rich guys.
But like you said, if you have a friend and they know your worth, you don't really need to show them your worth. They have to already know your worth.
Because by the time then you don't have to complain if they are not giving you what you expect, because they're your friends.
And that's what hurts. The fact that they're your friends and they do not. They don't know how to gift you. That hurts so much to the core.
Kati man, get more friends like body.
Okay.
Get more friends like body because you know what to do.
But you're already my friend.
No, like more than friends.
Okay. Let us go for commercial break. When we come back, we are still talking about the gifting process. We're waiting for the last segment of the show. But make sure if you have missed the episodes that have been on this season 3, go down to our YouTube channel, that is Abba Television. You're gonna find them there. And of course, pick a leaf from what we're talking about, because these topics that we are talking about are helping you out there to figure out what your life is missing. So let us come back. You're still watching 7 Talk.